180! I'm just practicing darts in case any of my guests fancies a game. I have some super brilliant guests coming in today for a drink and event before heading to sit round the table with Alan Davies. Did you get that one? Because that was a bullseye. Not at all. Thank you so much for coming to my bar today.
It's a pleasure. Nice pleasure you got here.
It's really nice. Do you like my sign?
Yes, your sign's particularly good.
I'll say this. We're in front of a dartboard right now. I feel like you are the darts generation.
Well, you may think I'm the darts generation, but I am no dart player.
Let's just be honest. You just came in and got a bullseye before we started recording.
I'm terrible at darts, but I mean, it's, you know, I did, before we started filming, I did throw a bullseye. But there we are. Should we play?
Three, you get three shots, and I just want to...
Three arrows, I believe. I don't know, it's the same thing. Shots are what you serve at the bar.
Actually, that wasn't great.
It's not great.
This actually makes me feel a lot better about myself.
You should feel better about yourself. 40 to beat.
Do you have to call it? Is it like Uno?
You have to shout, 20 times three!
20 times three!
That's eight.
Shut up, because if you talk, I'll be distracted and I'll get angry at you, and that's not your fault.
Okay.
20 times three!
One.
20 times three! I'm going to level with you, that was embarrassing.
Save some blushes for something more worthwhile.
Could I just make a call for the pub? Yeah. I actually don't think I want a dartboard in it anymore.
Okay, fine. Well,
I think just Jenga on every table. I think that's totally reasonable. Can you please tell me a bit about how the pub landlord character came about?
So I was doing a show in Edinburgh.
Yeah.
In a bar, the Pleasance Cabaret Bar, with Harry Hill.
Okay, wow.
And I was meant to compare, and I'd come up with a thing that didn't work. just crap, I hadn't thought
it
through.
Tell me what you did, though.
Oh, I did this sort of old kind of vaudeville guy who did terrible jokes, and it was just... The mistake I made is I wrote a thing I thought comedians would like rather than a thing I thought was sort of funny. You know?
I'm still learning.
I mean, this is an amazing discovery to make when you're a young comic, because people want to laugh.
I really wish someone had told me in my first year, though.
Well, you see. Anyway, so I said, well, look, for the comparing, how about I say, well, I go on and say that the compare hasn't shown up and the barman who's offered to fill in.
So good.
And I wrote down five or six jokes or ideas.
Yeah.
Went on, did them, they got laughs, came off, he went on and did his 40 minutes, and I'm like, crap, better write some more stuff. So the next day, I cut all my hair off because he had to be bald.
He had to be bald, or he had to be shorn
at least. It's something of a commitment. But people think I also get this thing. People think I'm bald.
No, they don't. I didn't think
no,
you
no,
were
people
bald.
No, people go, oh, baldy. Yeah. I'm not bald. It's a haircut. But you know, what can you do? And by the end of the tour with this show, I had an act like came out of nowhere. So suddenly I had to do a lot more, you know, basic MCing. Which and the pub landlord is a. He's an MC. The idea is he comes to the bar and he goes, that drink's crap, should be drinking that, look at your terrible... What do you do for a living anyway? Oh, right, OK, that's wank, right? And that's basically the premise. I mean, it's an accident. It was designed to fill 5 minutes and it's kept me busy for almost 30 years now.
Could you just give me, like, a vague vibe for your drink?
Obviously. Ginger.
I don't have ginger. Like so when I say vibe, you have to pick from what I suggest.
Well, if we make a drink that's all the creamy things together, so the pina colada stuff and the Kahlua might be nice.
You can have all the creamy stuff, we will do that.
I sent you a message asking you to come to dinner at my house and I thought it would be nice and then you didn't.
I'm gonna level with you. Your house, haunted.
No, that's my last house.
Okay,
that's my last
the
house,
ghost
this one is
following
haunted.
People.
The ghost in my old flat, I woke up during the night and there was just like a tap, tap, tap on this window. And I woke my boyfriend up and I was like, there's a ghost. And he said, I've told you, stop waking me up at 4 a.m. and say there's ghosts, which always happens in horror films. There's got to be one person that doesn't believe in it.
Mystery box one or mystery box two?
I have a much scarier ghost story than my first one. Number two, please. Is it okay if I have my drink? I'm quite thirsty. Is that veggie, mate?
No, obviously it's not.
It's veggie, mate.
It's a mystery ingredient.
Can I have a soda water, please?
Right, this is just an amuse-bouche, though. You're still getting an actual cocktail. I have not had a guest like this so far.
I used to make cocktails. You're supposed to do this.
With your hands?
No, but I had to improvise in the absence of a good barmaid.
Mm. Right, you're getting a lot more of that now.
That's milk, isn't it?
It's not milk, it's pina colada mix.
Did you put Vegemite in it?
No, it's a mystery ingredient.
Okay.
You're overthinking it. What's the scariest ghost story, though?
Well, when I was 16, the guy I was going out with at school, he said his house was haunted, which was mad because it wasn't like an old fancy house. It was just a council house in Bathgate. His mum was like, yeah, it's pure haunted because we phoned all the spooky lines and they just hang up on us as soon as we phone up. And that costs £1.50 a minute, so why would they hang up on me? Unless it was like a malevolent spirit.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so we decided to have a seance there.
Good idea.
We filmed it, but then we were teenagers and at some point in the night you just forget that you've left the video camera on. And we were sitting by the table all just eating a big tin of Quality Street because we weren't old enough to drink.
That feels like a really important detail. Thank you for giving it to me.
It is important. There were all these wrappers on the table and when we watched the video back, you see the wrappers get pushed down and moved across
Shut
the table.
Up.
Then, cause the camera's behind my friend, she keeps going like this and just absent-mindedly brushing her shoulder. From the back, you saw her dress just be pulled away.
This is so intense. My
friend lent the video to these people in Lockerbie and then they never gave it back. So now we just sound like people who are making it up.
No, I believe
you. But it happened.
Honestly believe that.
Well, honestly, it happened.
I used to have Queen Victoria's ghost come visit me when I was a child. And everyone was like, oh, it's just Queen Victorians
at
school.
Why would she go to Fleet? Queen Victoria... Well, would she not want to mix with, like...
She will go where she wishes. Fern, before you try it, it's got everything you wanted in it. You've been spending way too much time with your cats, babe.
That's not as bad as you were wanting it to be. It's all right.
I wanted it to be nice. I was not...
Well, it's genuinely like how people put miso in ice cream and desserts and stuff.
Yeah.
That's the effect the Vegemite's had.
What do you want to call it?
Umami tea?
Umami tea.
My mummy umami.
That's what. Write it on the board. Please write it on the board. Umami tea. Under menu, and then can you put a 4 out of 5 and a smiley face, please? Would it be wrong for me to say that I think your biggest accomplishment is the fact that you had a crisp named after you?
Well, that actually is right up there in the pantheon of life experiences. And I've even got the foil roll. They gave me some foil roll of the bag that I have hanging up in my downstairs loo of the artwork, like that.
I think it's every pub person's dream is to have a crisp named after them. Bauer's Bar is new,
yeah.
So I don't have my own crisp yet.
Yeah.
I have been working on some flavours. Would you mind trying them
and
telling me what you think?
I'd love to try your flavours.
Yes!
So to speak.
This is my first flavour.
Oh, they're sort of soggy.
They will be crisped up on the day.
This is the day.
This isn't the day. This is not my crisp release day. Yummy. Tasty.
Oh, they're spicy. Crikey.
But...
Very spicy, fiery.
That was lime and Tabasco crispy.
Yeah, but... Crikey. They need to come with a warning.
But I'm a bit spicy as well.
What have these got on them? Sarin.
This one I think is very clear. And this for me is my favourite flavour. Oh, what have I told you? I'm from France.
What, a garlic?
Yeah. That's good, isn't it?
It was uncanny. It was like we were in Bordeaux.
Merci beaucoup.
C'est pas problème. Okay. Okay.
Garlic. This is more of a you flavour, I fear. On a roast.
I was going to say they're a bit porky.
It's gravy.
Yeah.
Do you love it?
Yeah, they're great. They're great. I'd eat gravy-flavoured crisps.
And this I would describe as your puddy crisp.
They look sort of sweaty, those.
You know what? I would have said pussy, so I'm actually okay with... Okay. Actually, okay. Don't think about that. Just try it.
I'm not sure botulism-flavoured crisps would kick off, but...
Yummy,
is that
yummy.
Custard?
Yes!
They're horrible.
No, because people put salt in things now, like salted caramel. I thought maybe a salty... No?
No. The gravy is... at the top of the line there.
Thank you so much for coming.
It's my pleasure.
If I could take a drink order.
Yeah, can I have a really big glass of red wine, please?
That's what I would drink.
A really big glass of red wine.
Any particular one?
Something from Germany.
I'll make sure you have it.
Yeah.
Juicy.
Juicy juice. Danke. Yeah.
Let us know who you'd like to visit Bauer's Bar next week in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to Dave and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on all of our fresh content. And head over to UKTV Play to watch all episodes of Alan Davies As Yet Untitled for free.